Hello, my dear young ladies. I hope that you have finished my previous classes and you have taken attempt to finish those exercises and assignments that I have given to you. Today, I'm going to start with a new lesson, and that is voice change. In your exam, you have to answer them in the questions of changing sentences. Okay, today's lecture is about voice, active and passive voice. And as we know that we have to change these voices from one kind to another, like from active to passive or from passive to active, for example. Let's go for that. Look at the slide here. There is a diagram about classification of voice. That means voice are two kinds, active and passive. And there is also an example. Look at this. In active, we can say like Ram killed Ravan. In passive, that would be Ravan was killed by Ram. Now, the first question that may occur in your mind that why we need to know this voice change? That is a common question in mind. And what we can do by changing voices from active to passive or from passive to active? They are actually excellent question for learning something. Now, let's go for the answer of this question. Basically, it is useful to know that you have two types of sentences, active and passive. That way, you can use them in your speech and writing and understand them when you hear them. We usually use active sentence, but sometimes it is better to use passive sentence. For example, when you want to tell about an action, but you don't want to mention who does it, or you are not interested that much to focus about the person who had done that. Okay? So, let's have an example that would be more clear then. For example, I'm having an active voice, like a sentence like Sylvia ruined the party. It is clear who did it, isn't it? Who did the party? Who ruined the party? Sorry. Yes, Sylvia. That means here I am focusing the subject. Okay, who ruined the party? But if I say like that, the party was ruined. Is there any mention about the person who did that? No, but the same information about the action is given here, isn't it? And that is passive form of voice. We can also talk like that. The party was ruined by Sylvia. That is also giving us same impression, but we are having the information still that Sylvia ruined the party. But we can also say like that, the party was ruined. I'm here emphasizing on the action more, rather than the person who did that. The focus is changed here when I'm not interested to give focus on the person who had done that. Then I can use passive form. Here you only describe what happened without mentioning who actually did it, or you are actually doing that just sometimes we do mention just to give information, not for highlighting, by using by Sylvia. Okay. Another use of the passive voice is when you want to emphasize the object instead of the subject. Usually in active voice, what we did, we said Sylvia ruined the party. I'm emphasizing the action of Sylvia. Sylvia is the subject, emphasizing subject. But when I want to emphasize the object instead of subject, there object was the party. And if I want to emphasize the party, then what I have to do? Yes, I have to speak in passive form, like I have done. The party was ruined. Then all the attention and focus is with the object. Okay. Let's have another example. It would be more clear then. Like, Bob closed the store. Here, the emphasis or actually the emphasis is on Bob, okay, doing the action. What was done by Bob? He closed the door and Bob is getting the focus. But if I say the store is closed, here the emphasis is on the fact that the store is closed. In sentence, Bob closed the store. Bob was subject, closed verb. The store was the object. And what I have done in passive form? I have given emphasis to the object instead of subject. I'm repeating it again. In passive voice, sometime we actually want to emphasize the object instead of the subject, and that I have done here also. Okay. I think it would be more clear in next slides. Be with me. Let us look at the slide very carefully. In this slide, we are having active voice and passive voice and their important characteristics. Look at that. Active voice. What happens in active voice? In active voice, the focus is the person or thing doing the action. That means who is doing, that means subject is the main focus in active voice. And what happens? Yes, the actor is the subject of the sentence actually. Now look at the example. The example is, I finished my assignment. Here, I is the actor, it is subject. And then finished, we know, finished is verb, past form of verb. And then my assignment, that means this is the thing that is regarded as object. Okay, now what is the main focus here? Yes, the subject, I, is getting the main focus here. Okay, now let's go for the passive voice. What happens in passive voice? In passive voice, the person or the thing receiving the action is the focus there. That means this time, who is receiving the action is the main focus. That means the object is main focus here. And passive voice is used when the person or thing doing the action is not important. That means the subject, which was in active voice, is not important in passive voice. Listen to me very carefully. The subject that was actually main focus in active voice, that will not be the main focus in passive voice. Okay? And when we do not know the person or the thing doing the action, that means when we don't have any idea about who has done that, in that case, we also use passive voice. Now look at the example. We have that sentence in active voice as, I finished my assignment. But when we are changing that in passive voice, what we're going to write? Yes, look at the slide. That time, we're going to write that, my assignment was finished. Now, be careful and listen very carefully that I was subject, finished was verb, my assignment was object. Now, what happens in passive voice? Yes, this time that object from active voice is becoming the subject in passive voice and getting the all focus. Yes, my assignment is subject here. My assignment was finished. And I can also write like, my assignment was finished by me. Both are correct. But as because we have to write for exam paper, I think you can use the second one. My assignment was finished by me. But in conversation, it is not needed. And it is not important to write by, say, by me or by him or by this. Okay? Now, as I have discussed about this pattern, there is a confusion or there is a query in your mind about subject, about object, and about why the changing is like was finished. Why it is nothing else like is being finished or something like that. Why I'm just using was finished. Yes, there is a certain criteria or rule for doing that. We are going for that in our next slide. So we are going by step after step. Okay, be with me. Now, let's try to find out the process of locating subject from a sentence. As because for changing voice, it is very important to have the idea about subject, verb, and object. Because by changing, just by changing the places of subject and object, we can work with other voice form. Okay, now let's go for that. What is subject? The subject is the noun or pronoun in a clause or sentence that performs the action of the verb. That means doer, who is doing the action. He is the subject. It is the subject. They are the subject. It can be noun or pronoun. So we have to keep in mind that it would be related with noun or pronoun, not other kind of parts of speech. One option is that way we can find out subject from sentence. One way to find subject of a sentence is to find verb first. Yes, after you have found the verb, ask who or what before it, and the answer will be the subject. Like, stone walls towered in front of her. Stone walls towered in front of her. The verb is, let's find out the verb. Yes, which one is verb here? Try to guess. Yes, towered. Now ask who or what here. Who towered or what towered? Yes, walls, that means stone walls. So which one is the subject? Yes, stone walls here is the subject. Now, you may have another question, that when we are having question type of sentences, how we are going to find out our subject. In that case, you can find the subject by turning the question into statement. That is the basic way. No other alternative. You have to do that. And then use the above method of finding the verb and subject. Am I clear? I think. If you are not, stop it again and come from the very beginning. It would be easier. Okay? Now, this time our attempt is to find out object. And to find the object of a sentence, you must understand the sentence and use that understanding to identify the individual components that make up its meaning. As we have already discussed that the nouns in a sentence are subject, but this time I'm going to say you that nouns or pronouns in a sentence are either subjects or objects, with subjects being the focus of the sentence and objects being details provided in the sentence to shed additional light on the action of the subjects. Actually, that means that I have already said in previous lecture or previous slide that subject is doer, who is doing the action, and object is actually receiving that action, or the verb is actually falling on or happening with the object. Am I clear? Okay, now, as because I have said that nouns and pronouns, subjects and objects are actually nouns or pronouns. Now, let's have an example. Actually, two examples we are having here in the slide, the pink portion in the slide. Look at that. The fruit fell on the lion. The fruit fell on the lion. Now, let's go back to the criteria that we have used, or the process to find out the verb at first. Which one is the verb? Yes, I have mentioned here that fell is the verb, and I have indicated the verbs with red. Okay, fell is the verb, and who fell, what fell, I'm questioning it with who or what. Yes, what fell? The fruit fell. Yes, that means the fruit is the subject. Okay, and then on whom or who is receiving the falling action? The lion. Falling on whom? The lion. That means lion is receiving the action of falling. Okay, the lion is object here. Now look very closely. The fruit is a name. Okay, this is a noun. Okay, and the lion, that is another kind of noun. So here we can say that subject and object both are nouns or pronouns. Let's go for the second one. Look, I asked her. Asked is the verb. Okay. Who asked? What asked? Who asked? I asked. That means I am subject. Okay. And who is receiving the action of asking? Who is receiving the asking? Her. That means her is object here. So here I am using subject I. I is a noun? No, it is not noun. It is pronoun. And who is receiving the action? Her. Her is also pronoun. So we can say that subjects and objects can be nouns or pronouns. And we have already learned how to find out them, how to find out the nouns, sorry, subject and object in a sentence. Let's go for two more examples. Our cat caught a mouse. Go for the verb at first. Yes, caught is the verb. So subject is our cat. Yes, very good. Now, who is receiving the action of caught? Who is caught? Yes, a mouse is caught. Who is receiving the action of catching? Yes. That means a mouse is an object. Caught what? A mouse. Okay. Now the second one. The boss saw her in town. Saw is the verb. Okay. And I'm asking with who saw, what saw, saw what or whom? Yes, saw her. That means receiving the action. Saw is the verb. That means the boss is doing that action of seeing. The boss is here subject. And the saw action is actually working for her, falling on her. She is receiving the action of saw. For that reason, her is the object here. And in town is actually extension with object. Okay? I think it is now more clear. Okay, now as we have already learned about subject, object, and we have learned about the changing basic process of voice, now let's go for something more. That means basic rules of changing voice. Okay, we are having example here. The example is, we are reading a newspaper. This is now in active form, and we know that when something is in active form, the focus is on, yes, subject. Yes, which one is the subject? We is the subject, and we are having verb reading, and the object is a newspaper. And if I want to change that in passive voice or in passive form, what am I going to do? Now let's go for the basic rules. What are the basic rules telling us about the process of changing voices? And according to grammatical lessons or grammatical different measures, we have tried to gather the information about changing. And as a whole, we can say that if we keep in mind these four rules, it would be easier for you to change the voice, and it would be easier for you to take decision what to do after what. Okay, now the first one, what we have to do when we want to change voice from active to passive or from passive to active. First one is that subject changes its function. Our subject is we. Okay, then we have to change its function. And we have a subject. When subject changes its function in voice change, as we have already know, it would become object. Okay, fine. That means subject changes into object form. An object changes its appearance to subject. Okay? Okay. Like in our example, we are going to find that a newspaper becomes subject in passive voice, and we become object, like us, by us. Okay. And then the second one, our second rule is that subject and object interchange their placement also. Yes, that is happening with our example. Like, what we have done? We are reading a newspaper that was in active form. When we are making it passive form, what we have done? We have written a newspaper is read by us. We have given the place of subject to the object. That means a newspaper is coming to the place of subject and we is going to the place of object. That means they are interchanging. They are crisscrossing their placement. Number three. Past participle form of principal verb is used when we change active voice to passive. Yes, that also happened with our example. In our sentence, our verb was reading. That means the main verb of this one would be, that means principal verb is read. So what would be the past participle form? Read, read, read. Okay, that means read. When I have changed that into passive form, I use that read, okay? And as because a newspaper is singular, I have used the is auxiliary form here. Okay, now, in passive voice, the opposite happens. That means a principal verb becomes past participle in active voice. But in passive voice, past participle again go back to its principal form, okay? Okay. Now, last one, but the important one, that is auxiliary verb changes its form. Remember, auxiliary verb changes its form. And there is nothing to become actually tensed how to deal with that, because voice change is something that actually governs by something very fixed rules, and we have some basic information and charts for learning them. I'm going to give you them in your next slide, so be with me. Before starting any discussion with this slide, I want to give you a homework. Yes, that is, you have to draw these two charts separately in two A4 size pages with bold and large letters. Then you have to hang them on your wall, which would be close to your mirror, or in that would be close to your reading table or in front of your reading table, and you have to memorize them. I want them like that because I want to have them in front of your eyes always. So you do feel the need of memorizing them, and you have to memorize them if you want to learn voice change accurately. Okay, so that is your homework. Now let's start our discussion. In first chart, we are having information about change of auxiliary verbs. They are all together 10 in number, and like first sentence is we have to know about tense. I do think that you do know about tense, and you have to idea about tense also. Now look at this. Number one, if the sentence is in present indefinite, then if you are having do, does, or base form of verb in active voice, you have to change that auxiliary into am, is, are. Like if I am saying a sentence like teenagers love fashion magazines. Teenagers love fashion magazines. Here the subject is teenager, verb is love. We don't have any auxiliary. We are having base form of verb directly. So if I want to change that in passive voice, according to the changing rules that we have learned before, we have to change the subject and object places and their action. Like I'm going to change like fashion magazines, as because that is in plural form, which am I going to pick? Which one I'm going to pick? Am. Is or are? Yes, are. I'm going to pick are. That means it would be fashion magazines are, and my verb is love. And we do know that in passive voice, always the main verb or the principal verb would become past participle of verb. Past participle form of the verb. So love would become love, loved, loved. That means it would become loved. So what I'm going to write? Fashion magazines are loved by whom? By teenagers. Okay, that is the passive form. That means in voice change, we are not going to change the basic thing about changing verbs. Our verb would, a main verb or principal verb would always become past participle form in passive voice. But this chart is only about auxiliary verb. Keep that in mind. Don't get tensed or don't mix up these two things. Your main verb would always become past participle in passive voice. This chart is only about auxiliary verb. Okay, now let's go for the second one. Second one is talking about the present continuous type of sentence. And if that sentence is having am, is, or are, then you are going to change that as am being, is being, are being. Number three, if we are having a present perfect sentence, and in that sentence, if we have, has in active form, we are going to change that into have been, has been. Number four, in past indefinite type of sentence, if we are having did or past form of main verb or principal form of verb in our active voice, then we are going to change them as was or were in passive voice. Now, number five, past continuous. If the sentence is in past continuous and if we are having was, were in was or were in active voice, then we are going to change them as was being, were being in passive voice. Number six, past perfect sentence. If that sentence is inactive and if that is having had as auxiliary, we are going to change that as had been in passive form. Number seven, future indefinite sentence. If the sentence is in future indefinite and that is giving us active form, shall will become shall be will be in passive form. Number eight, future continuous. Shall be, will be, will become shall be, being, will be, being. And in number nine, future perfect sentence, if that is having shall have or will have, then we are going to change that as shall have been, will have been. And number 10 is talking about modal auxiliary and others. Modals are, we know, can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would. These are the modals, and other auxiliaries like am to, is to, are to, was to, these are other auxiliaries. And I have given a elaborate information here with this. I think it should be clear for you. Try to memorize them. There is no other way to work with that. Okay. Okay. Now let's come for the next one. This chart is giving us information about this is actually about change of pronominal subject and object. Like as I have changed, like the sentence was before that, we love our country. Our country, we love our country. Our country is loved by us. Here, we become us. Why? That was the question in your mind. I have changed different times like that. Now, this is the answer. This is the way of changing, and you have to memorize them. Okay, now let's go for that. In active voice, if we have I, in passive voice, we are going to make that me. That is also the vice versa. If we are having me, we are going to make it I. We are going to have we in active, then we are going to change that as us in passive. You become you. You doesn't change. She become her, he become him, they become them, and name of anything remains same. It doesn't change. Okay, that is the thing about this chart or about this actually information. So try to memorize them. Let's go for the next one. But before going for the next one, let me remind you that you have to make a lecture sheet on the whole voice change also. This is for your own benefit. Okay? Okay. This time we are going to evaluate our learning. How much we have learned through these previous slides, it would be clearer if we can manage these examples here. Let's try it. Okay. If in active voice we have the sentence in present simple, like that means present indefinite, like they make cars in Germany, what would be in passive? They make cars in Germany. we are having main verb or the principal verb without any auxiliary. According to the rule, what we know, if we don't have any auxiliary, we are having just base form. What are the options we are having? Am is are. Yes, am is are. So the passive form would be yes, cars, plural, are. We are going to pick are as because the cars is in plural form, are. Make in past participle form would be made. Yes, cars are made in Germany. Yes, very good. Now the second one, if the sentence of active voice is in present continuous, and if we are having the sentence like mother is baking a cake, we are having mother is baking a cake. Subject is mother, a cake is object. We have to change their place and we have to think about auxiliary. We are having is an ing form. That means what we are going to do? Yes, I'm going to change the place at first. A cake is being for M is R ing. A cake is being, bake would become past participle form, baked. A cake is being baked by mother. Good. Now, past simple or past indefinite form. If we have in our active voice, the example can be like J.D. Salinger wrote The Catcher in the Rye. Who wrote? J.D. Salinger. Okay, fine. Now, if I want to change that voice, I'm going to change the subject and object. Which one is the object? Yes, so this is looking like a complete one, but this is the object. The Catcher in the Rye, name of a text. Okay, so it would become subject. Then I would write The Catcher in the Rye. Write is the main verb that is in past indefinite or past simple form. So it would become was or were. Is it singular or plural thing? This is singular, so I would take was. The catcher in the rye was, wrote, that means main form is write. Past participle would become write, wrote, written. So what would be the changed sentence in passive? The catcher in the rye was written by J.D. Salinger. Clear? Okay. Now, past continuous. We are having all the things given here. You just have to read them very carefully and try to manage by yourself at first. Okay, without looking at the passive voice. Next time when you are doing by yourself the slide. Second visit of the slide. Okay. I think one vision or one watching of a slide in grammar is not enough for learning. Twice, thrice is, I think, important for understanding. Memorizing is more than that, for understanding something clearly. So in first one, listen to me carefully. But in second one, stop the voice. Try to do it by yourself without looking at the passive voice. Okay? Okay. Now, in past continuous, we are having a sentence like they were watching TV when I got home. It is becoming like TV was being watched when I got home, because auxiliary was, were, and continuous form of verb becomes was being, were being, then past participle form of the verb. For that reason, what we have changed? We have said that TV was being watched when I got home. Number 5. Present perfect sentence pattern. I have cleaned my room. Has or have cleaned, when we are having have or has as auxiliary, what we are going to do? Have been, has been. And as usual, the main verb would become past participle form. We have to change the subject, object, place, that's all. Okay. So what I'm going to do? I have cleaned my room, that is inactive. I'm going to say my room. This is in singular. Yes, my room has been cleaned. Okay, number 6, past perfect sentence. Thomas had read the book before he saw the film. Thomas had read the book before he saw the film. In past perfect, if we are having that inactive like that, what we are going to do? Had. Had would become had been. And past participle of main verb. Okay. The book had been read by Thomas before he saw the film. Okay. Okay. Now number 7. Future simple. Similarly, we are having the passive form. And number 8 is also given here. I think these are nothing that much tough. In our next class, we are going to actually analyze our active and passive voice form in different type of sentence category, as because that is my target to be there for preparing yourself. The first lecture was actually made. In next class, that would be actually our desired goal, how we are going to face them for our exam. Thank you very much for being with me. Thank you so much for being attentive and regular. I do miss you, my dear young ladies. Hope to meet you soon in our regular classroom learning process. So let's pray for each other till then.